Last Sunday, I got an idea for something that I wanted to see on the internet. I wanted to take your GitHub username, scrape some information, and then tell you something nice. So I made it in a couple hours, I released it to the world, tweeted about it, and then I went to go play video games. To my surprise, it went viral. The GPU node was not happy, and it was on its last legs, teetering towards failure. I've been in SRE before, but I've never really handled GPU-specific issues. What I did know is that requests to the Ollama server should take about 20 seconds to process. They were taking 3 minutes, or even timing out. This was very wrong. After thinking a bit, I realized that I had committed one of the SRE cardinal sins. I had accidentally created an unbounded work queue, causing too much work and not enough to do it with, a general Kvutla failure. So I started up another couple GPU nodes with fly vol fork and then fly scale count 3, and I was barely able to keep up with requests. I just needed more GPUs. Then I tried to add a fourth. I ran into capacity issues. To be fair, I should have expected issues when I was scaling up this aggressively, this quickly, without coordinating with my coworkers. Even though Fly.io has some of the latest and greatest in NVIDIA technology, there's still hard physical caps on the number of cards that are available at any one given time, even though Sunday afternoon is usually a low point for these things being utilized. There still just wasn't capacity because there's not many of those cards physically in the data center. In order to scale up, I was going to have to change the GPU that I was using to do inference. One of the problems was that all of the other GPUs are technically inferior to the A180GB that I was using. As an SRE, it feels kinda weird to be scaling down at the same time that you're scaling up. Normally when you scale things, there's horizontal scaling for adding more nodes or vertical scaling for making your nodes bigger. But what I was doing was kind of a diagonal scaling where I was getting more nodes, but making those nodes less capable each. Either way, this was the only path forward, and I had two GPUs to choose from, the A180GB and the L40S. The decision really came down to two factors. One, there's a lot more L40S cards available in Seattle, where basically nobody uses them, and the L40S has 48GB of VRAM because it's an RTX 4090 with twice the VRAM. My app was using Llama 3.1 70 billion to do text synthesis. That is 39GB of weights. Plus inference space, it was 47.8GB of VRAM usage. The L40S was realistically the only option I had. Here's where I made my first mistake. I instantly spun down my A100 in San Jose, and then started spinning up my L40Ss in Seattle. One unique thing about large language model applications is that you need to download the model weights before they can be used. Every single user that was trying to get nice words of praise about their GitHub profile just got an error, model doesn't exist message. This is not a good user experience, so I had to act quickly. Forking the volume from San Jose to Seattle was not really a reasonable option. So what I did is I used WireGuard to get into each of the Ollama servers and pull down the model weights as fast as I could. I also disabled the web application at the same time so that I would have less errors and chaff in the logs. Once I had more GPUs available, I turned back on the web app. A flood of requests came in. Inference times were slowly crawling up. I realized that I needed more GPUs fast. Here's where I made mistake number two when I was responding to this. What I should have done is forked the volume over to another physical computer box in the Seattle data center so that I don't have to download the model's weights manually, but I didn't do that. I thought I would be clever. What I did instead is I used fly machine run to create a new ephemeral Ollama runner, and then I did Ollama serve and to run Ollama server in the background, and then did Ollama pull llama 3.1:70b to pull the 70 billion parameter model. And with a little bit of elbow grease, I had 7 GPUs in the pool. Either way, it worked. Requests were being balanced between the 7 GPUs, and I felt confident enough to go back to playing my video games. To my delight, the fixes worked. All the traffic was being handled, and the fact that I was on the front page of the dreaded Citrus forum didn't change anything. Quest time was stable, users were happy, and I got screenshots sent to me on whatever we're supposed to call Twitter now. Mission accomplished. In the process of responding to this fire, I learned a few things. The first big thing is that GPU scaling is kind of an art right now. There's not really any best practices for this because, like, the entire industry changes the state of the art every 2 weeks. There is literally not enough time for best practices to develop, not even for models that were released a year ago. In order to cope with load, sometimes you have to think out of the box and disregard common sense, like scaling to a bunch of worse GPUs in order to get the job done. I was once again reminded of the danger of unbounded work queues and how easy they are to create on accident. Unbounded work queues as a problem kinda suck because it's one of the easiest things to do on accident, right next to a thundering herd problem. And the only real way to combat it is to know how much load your services can take, which means you have to do load testing, which means that you have to figure out how to know things. Maybe I chose the wrong model here. Llama 3.170B is one of the best models that you can get that runs on a single GPU, and I chose it for that. But in the process, you have to be able to run 70 billion parameters, and the more parameters means longer inference times, and it was just kind of inconvenient. Maybe I should have gone with the 8 billion parameter model. At least that's what I was using in testing on my MacBook. If you want to try it for yourself, the link is in the description and on screen right here. Share it with your friends. Maybe they'll like what they get. If you want to try GPUs on fly.io, check the description. There's a link for $50 of free credit to help you get started. This is more than enough to let you get started tinkering with apps like Praise My GitHub Profile. Other than that, have a good day, subscribe, make sure to stay hydrated, and stay frosty.